Hello, sentient traffic lights. Today we are reviewing Unreal Life, a game that comes to us from developer Heiko Life and publisher Room 6. I played this one on Steam, where it is currently available for $19.99. It is also available on the Switch for $22.99. Unreal Life is a puzzle adventure game that tells the story of a young girl named Hal who wakes up in the middle of the street without her memories, or at least without most of them, and with the assistance of a very helpful traffic light called 195, who communicates with her through her brain. Bear with me here, this story is quite a doozy, but trust me, it's worth it. So this traffic light communicates with her through her brain, and they try to piece together who she is, where she came from, and what she's looking for. Oh, and by the way, they figure out that when she touches objects, she can see the memories of said objects and look a little bit back into the past. She has no idea why she has this ability or if she's always had it, but she does find it helpful in figuring out where she's going and solving one of the many puzzles. One thing she knows for certain is that she is looking for a woman by the name of Miss Sakura. She does not know who Miss Sakura is to her, only that she has to find her. And with that, you dive deep into the rabbit hole of this game, and I mean that fully as an Alice in Wonderland pun, because this game really reminds me of Alice in Wonderland, and I don't know whether it's just the nonsensicalness of the story or the kind of whimsical characters, but where else would you find yourself getting meals from a moss ball chef and talking to a mouse, I think, who is the engineer for a train station? So, gameplay-wise, you are essentially just wandering around this world, touching objects to gain some information on their history, collecting key items to solve puzzles, and interacting with the whimsical characters of this world. Since Hal has lost her memories and her brain's a little fuzzy to begin with, you do have the option of looking back on your conversations, on the history of objects that you've touched, as well as other story points that you might not remember off the top of your head. This way you can keep everything organized. You do also have the option to do a manual save, which is what they call Hal sleeping in her bed, just in case you think you might forget something. As you're exploring the world, for the most part, most of the items you can interact with are highlighted. However, there are some instances where a key object will not be highlighted and you'll kind of need to stand in the vicinity of it and press the interaction button in order to discover it. You do also have an inventory where you can carry key items that you may need in order to interact with certain characters or gain insight into Hal's memories. There are also some sort of portal doors that will pop up periodically throughout your explorations, and all portals lead back to Hal's bedroom, just in case you do want to make a save. Now, if you are wondering how long this game will take to complete, that will really depend on whether you want to get all endings and achievements, because there is a decent amount of replayability here with the different endings, so you could be playing upwards of 10 hours. As you can tell, Unreal Life has a gorgeous pixel style to the graphics. All of the characters had such a cool look to them, particularly, you know, your main characters, Hal, and even the traffic light, 195, which it's so weird to say that the traffic light was a main character, but trust me, just go with me on this, it was, and they gave it personality, and it worked really surprisingly well. Overall, the game has a very blue hue to it, and this kind of monochromaticness I think really helps set this tone of the game as well. Even with the similar color scheme in all of the locations, there is definitely a good variation to the places that you travel, but you can never really shake the feeling that you're kind of almost underwater with the color. The sound design was similarly melancholy a lot of the times. There's a lot of kind of ambient synth tracks, some that sounded like almost a beautiful piano piece in the background that really complemented the mood of the game. And you have these great little sounds for the characters. There's no voice acting, but they make these little squeaky sounds, and It was really cute and really pleasing to listen to, and it also made the more energetic tracks stand out all the more, so you could really tell when there is a suspenseful event happening. I play a lot of games, and I have to gauge my enjoyment of a game on how much it stands out to me from the catalog of games that I play, and this one is going to stick with me for a long time. I really liked the characters, I liked the story, I like that there are multiple endings and reasons to come back to this game. I found the interactions between characters humorous and heartwarming at the same time, and overall, I can't recommend this one enough. Now more than ever, I think it's important to play a game that requires us to suspend our disbelief for a little while and just dive into a whimsical world, and Unreal Life hits that right out of the park. Thank you so much for checking out our review of Unreal Life. If you'd like to see more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button below so you can follow all of our reviews and previews, and check out the description box for links to our merchandise store, as well as our Discord and our memberships if you'd like to support us further. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you next time.